Hello everyone, today we're going to be taking a look at the 10th Anniversary Reforged weapon set currently available on the cartel market in Star Wars The Old Republic. This is a quite expensive bundle. It costs 2,800 cartel coins and it comes with 6 different weapons. On top of that cost, if you want to unlock them across your entire account versus just the character you initially equipped them to, you can do so in collections, but each one costs an additional 400 cartel coins. So what's interesting about this set and why is it released? As part of the 10th anniversary of the game, the BioWare developers put these items that I have behind me, these decorations, out on the anniversary vendor, and you can actually get them almost for free. They are just simply something cool, like a weapon stand that you can put in your stronghold. And I assume players were asking, can we actually get these as weapons at some point? The decorations themselves have 5 weapons, almost one of each type, but we're missing the double-bladed lightsaber. However, you can get all 6 as part of that pack, the 10th Anniversary Reforged weapon set. So I took a look at these, and before I show them off to you, I'm going to give you a quick review. They are decent, a lot nicer textures than a lot of the older weapons, like especially when I'm zooming in on my big monitor. But they're nothing spectacular. I don't actually really recommend buying this pack unless you are an absolute diehard collector of everything, or if there was one that you happen to see that you just really, really want, and maybe you can sell the rest on the GTN. So now let's jump into the review. I'll show you what they look like, especially compared to their older versions, and what they sound like. This is the Reforged Derelict lightsaber. Here's what it looks like. It's quite thin. I'll show you its comparison of the previous Derelict lightsaber in a second. And here's what it sounds like. And here's where it gets interesting. So this is the new one that came out, the Reforged one. And here is the previous one, the Derelict lightsaber. So the really small one here on the left, it's a lot thinner. It has a completely different texture. Here's the older one. The older one has almost a plasticky texture and it's quite oversized. The biggest difference with the new one is it's the same kind of shape, but it has a higher quality metallic texture. You can especially see the texture improvements up at the top. And it has a kind of more realistic, less oversized size. So is it a huge improvement? Would you buy it or not? That's going to be up to you. This is the Reforged Derelict lightsaber. Here's what it looks like. It's quite thin compared to many other lightsabers. Can only zoom in so far, but you can see it's a decent quality texture. Nothing super special. Here's what it sounds like. And we'll take a look at it compared to its original non-reforged version as well. So here's what the new one looks like, the reforged version. And here's what the Derelict Saberstaff looks like in the original version. It's quite a bit larger and the texture is more visible. The reforged one is just kind of like a big long metal tube and the very thin banding. The old one is really thicker. Longer tube that has a more visible banding that looks like it's been weathered or roughed up a bit. This is the Reforged AD-1 Assault Cannon. Here's what it looks like. It's got a really high quality texture resolution, especially when you're zoomed in. Here's what it sounds like. Now what's interesting is, unlike the other weapons in this Reforged series, there is no counterpart to this one. There's no real old version to compare it to. It's kind of a unique weapon and they slap the Reforged title on it. The closest that we can find is there is some older weapons like the Havoc's Fist that kind of share the same shape, if not the same look. And the closest one that's currently more available is the Hyperstorm Cannon, and it's a dark version of that one. But the Hyperstorm, also a cartel market weapon, has a really cool glowy bit at the end, and the new one, the Reforged 80-1 Assault Cannon, does not have it. As far as I can tell, the colors on this weapon don't change with the color of a color crystal. They will remain green and don't change at all, even if you have a different color crystal in there. Here's the new Reforged Black Nebula Heavy Blaster. It's got a really high quality texture. None of these blinking or glowing lights change color with your color crystal. They're stuck to yellow and red. Here's what it sounds like. And here's where it gets interesting. The old one and the new one have a very huge difference when it comes to the quality of their textures. So here's the new one. Everything's super, super, super crisp. And here's what the old Black Nebula Heavy Blaster looks like. It's a lot more faded, especially when you zoom in, it looks a little bit blurry. All the animations and the shape are the same, but the texture is quite different. Very, very cool. I really like the new Reforged one. This is one of the few where I saw the difference and I was like, ooh, I think that might actually be a worthy upgrade. This is the Reforged Imperial E1 Blaster Rifle. Here's what it looks like. It has this little colorful bit right here where you can see the crystal. It's got a lot of weathering textures on the blaster. If you pull up a color crystal into the weapon, it will change color of the color crystal right here. And here's what it sounds like. And one really important thing when we compare it to its previous model, the one that isn't the Reforged version, here's what the new one looks like. Very high texture, it's just all kind of one color. But here's the old one. And this is where it gets kind of weird. This is the Imperial E1 Enforcer Blaster Rifle. And you'll notice this one's quite a bit of a different design cosmetically, like with the way it looks, because it has these paint stripes. There's a white paint stripe here, a yellow paint stripe, and it kind of continues across the whole blaster. And what was really cool about the Imperial E1 Enforcer Blaster Rifle, the original, is if you put a color crystal in there, it actually changed not only the color of the little flare in the center here, but it also changed the color of the entire weapon, so you could really make it match your outfit. The new one does not have that feature. The Reforged version does not have that feature at all. This is the Reforged Primordial Sniper Rifle. It's got a very dark wood grain right here and dark metal, and here's what it sounds like. And now I'll show you the original version of the Primordial Sniper Rifle. It's quite different here. Here's the original. And you see the very, very dark wood here. And here's the old version. We'll equip that real fast. Here's the original version. So as you can see, the new one is quite a bit of a higher texture. Whether that's enough that you'd want to go buy it, that's up to you. The old Primordial Sniper Rifle is very, very inexpensive. Very, very easy to get a hold of compared to probably this Reforged version.